With the application of suitable technology, people with physical disabilities are able to participate in various activities of daily living. When the Neil Squire Society was formed, much of the applied research of that time focused on developing devices to provide greater independence in the home environment. For example, personal computers have been adapted to provide people with entertainment, communications, and the necessary tools to allow them to return to school or get jobs. There are also other specialized devices that are more portable and can be mounted on a wheelchair to give people greater mobility and let them access powered doors and windows, telephones, lights and appliances, and entertainment electronics from anywhere in their homes. More recently, with the advent of wireless computing devices such as PDAs and smartphones, accessible mobile applications have now become a real possibility. These devices have the potential to extend a person's reach far beyond their home environment. The technology that's available today offers more than simple voice communications. People are accessing services that link them to the internet, let them send and receive text messages and video, play games, and purchase goods and services. Unfortunately, the main obstacle for people with dexterity limitations is the fact that there are currently few accessible input methods for mobile wireless devices. Several solutions exist for hands-free dialing, but there really isn't anything that provides access to all the applications and features on most mobile devices. Neil Squire researchers are currently working with several progressive thinking manufacturers and are looking at potential hands-free solutions that would enable people with disabilities to utilize wireless technology more effectively. The researchers are also evaluating the accessibility of wireless services before they become mainstream. This work includes surveys, focus groups, and usability studies to help identify the accessibility issues, as well as determine what types of next-generation services will best serve people with disabilities. For example, m-commerce or mobile commerce, which includes wireless banking and retail transactions, could offer a number of advantages over existing options. Mobile banking would allow access anytime and anywhere, with no lineups and increased privacy. Retail transactions are going the way of wireless as well. Some services already exist that allow people to purchase products via text messages or websites with their mobile phones. For retail store scenarios, smart cards and RFID chip-enabled phones are now offering people fast pay checkout options, similar to the way debit cards are used now but without the PIN process. For people who are unable to handle smart cards or mobile phones, alternative setups could be considered to accommodate wireless devices mounted on wheelchairs, for example. Credit card purchasing processes could be automated to the point where the buyers would simply confirm the total cost of the goods and then authorize payment with their wireless devices. Purchasing and handling tickets could also be made easier with wireless access. A person could simply enter a wireless area or zone close to the ticket machine. A wireless connection would be made automatically, and the purchasing instructions and selection buttons would appear on the person's portable device. An electronic version of the ticket could be stored for later retrieval and verification. Some of the most important wireless applications are those that can make it easier for people to get around. GPS-enabled phones could be invaluable for emergency-related services, as well as location-based services. For a person in a wheelchair, access to information can be helpful when planning and managing an outing in a downtown area. The ability to access transit schedules, maps, traffic alerts, or other such timely information could be more than just convenient. Also, with some continued research effort, wireless technology could be adapted to provide better access solutions, like connecting to apartment intercom systems, remotely controlling power doors, and even elevators in public buildings. So far, some progress has been made in removing physical barriers in public spaces, with curb cuts and sidewalks, accessible parking, and automatic doors, to name a few. However, access to many public services can still be difficult for some people. Mobile wireless devices and services that are designed for accessibility could make a significant difference, but further research and development is required to make this a reality.